G'day guys, welcome back. Welcome to Pouring Your Heart Out. Now, redemption video. When I did this one, I didn't look at my notes properly. So when I added the white, I only added 4 drops. I don't know why I only added 4 drops. Like normally it's a lot more, like 3 times the amount of drops. But because I was putting 4 drops into my color, I kind of forgot. So redemption. Same thing, I've dusted my mold with the yellow lemon sorbet from This Little Piggy and the orange red from Let's Resin. Dusted those. I will link that video up in the top right hand corner at the end of this video for you if you want to see me do that one. All right, let's do this properly this time. Okay. 1, 2, 3, feel free to fast forward. 4, I just give it a squeeze, wait till it comes to the top and I let go. 5, that way I'm not getting the drops too big, they're just the right amount. 6, give it a squeeze, wait, let it drop in. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Now the amount of drops that you're going to use is going to differ depending on what paste you use. That's my Bloom white pigment paste. I just leave it upside down like that so it can run in into the nozzle. So yeah, my Bloom pigment paste is really really strong. It's very saturated with white pigment paste. A lot of them are like 60% oil and only a little bit of paste. As we're speaking about that, I will show you. I have got, while I'm stirring, this is my black Cast and Craft. You wouldn't think it was, hey, it's been sitting on the shelf. There's a little bit of black in the bottom, like that, and the rest of it's all oil. So yeah, that's my black one. Haven't got the white one anymore. I used to use it, but now I just use my Bloom. I'm going to pay for oil. You use like twice. I know it sounds like I'm selling it, but you use like twice, 3 times the amount of some of the other pastes. But anyway, I'm using the Bloom today. Don't need very much. For like almost a half a cup of resin. All right, let's do the Quinacridone Magenta. This is a acrylic ink by Holbein. You can use a resin ink as well, just don't use a alcohol ink. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna see how we go with that. Might cut that back a little bit because on this one, like, it really took over. It's quite pink. Quite pink. So we'll see. Might add more yellow and less pink. The yellow gets lost, I find. Certain colors just get lost. Yellow is one of them. So I'm using the same resin. It's the Beast Bond that I got from Amazon. It's a pretty thick 1-to-1. Actually, I would call it a medium viscosity 1-to-1 resin. Relatively cost effective, I think. There's so many resins out there now, isn't it? I'm going to do 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8. That's the Hansa yellow. See how that looks. Now I'm not using those colored stones today because, well, you know, the color ran. It did. It actually marked my mold, which isn't going to come out on your resin on your next piece, but just discolors your mold. Like alcohol inks do. You know, if you put alcohol ink straight onto your mold and then you add your resin, like a reverse pour. Okay, I think those look good. Try not to mix them up too much. All right, so for the center, because it was kind of an orangish look last time, I'm going to use this. This is my Christmas glitter. I don't even know where it came from, but it's got gold and red in there, so I'm going to add a bit of that. I put a tiny bit of resin into
my cup already. So I'm just going to take a bit of a scoop of that one. See how that looks. I need some more. And a little bit of this gold stone. This is a more fine stone than the one that I used earlier. The one I used earlier today was quite a chunky. This one's only 0.5 to 2 millimeters chunkiness. So mainly gold with just a little hint of red. You can't even see that. Let's add a bit more. Let's add a bit more. I'll need a bit more resin then because it's quite chunky already. Just drizzle that in. Okay, that looks good. I'll try not to drop it into my work this time. I dropped it. If you didn't see it, I dropped it. I dropped it into here. But I did fix it afterwards. Well, I tried to fix it, and I showed you how I fixed it. So if you're interested, you can watch that video in case you ever do something like me and drop your stones where they're not supposed to be dropped. They're off here somewhere. All right, let's do the same thing. Let's pour that into the middle. So this is my new frangipani mold. It's the large one. I do have a small one as well, which is obviously smaller and not as deep. I'm doing a flower range for my edges because you know how I do my live edge with druzies and crystals and things like that. Well, now I'm doing a flower range, and I've got a rose and the frangipanis. And what else have we got? I've got a few. I've got sunflower, of course. All right, that's that one done. Now let's pour this in the center, and where the two colors meet, we should get a pretty orange. But for some reason, you end up with the colors reversing. You end up with the pink in the middle, which is really weird. I guess because the resin pulls from the outside in, that's what it does. Let's clean off my stick. All right, so that's that done. Give it a quick little torch. It's only a tiny little torch. Just be careful when you're torching. You don't want to fuse your resin to your mold. I've done that. Oops, all right, white. White is next. So we pour the white in, into the middle. It's nice and opaque this time. But if you like that sort of really delicate, ethereal looking petal, like it in the other one, when I only put 4 drops of white in, do that. Put less white in. Okay, so the you can see that the white's going underneath and that yellow's coming over the top. Not sure what it's doing there. Maybe that's a bubble. Not sure what that is. All right, let's do 2 drops of yellow. 1, 2. Just in there, that's gonna be our push. You can do clear if you want to, but I'm just gonna do some yellow. Hopefully get a little bit more yellow into it. Look at that. Doesn't that look pretty? I can feel it starting to warm up a little bit now. Just a touch. This resin, it says on the bottle, it's got 40 minute work time. Right, here we go. Pouring it into the middle. Like so. You try to reduce the size of your center without anything in it by kind of pouring a little bit slower. Tend to have a smaller center, but I don't know whether that actually works. I think I've tried that when I was doing lots of fairy flowers and things a few months back. Okay, so that's that done. Dunskies. Okay, it's looking quite orange, isn't it? You kind of lose the magenta look totally.
Actually, I shouldn't torch. Should not torch. Now, when I see a little hole like that, I tend to just want to cover it. I don't know whether it's just a... I don't know. I don't know what it is. It's a bubble. I don't know. Drop of alcohol. I'm not sure what it is. Okay. Now, this is where I always wonder if I should put this in now or wait. See, I like to wait, and then if I need to, I can syringe a little bit out of the center if I need to, because I don't think it's going to close all that well. In saying that, the resin is getting thicker, so I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do it now. Take a little bit out of the middle now, and just sort of encourage it to close. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I just use a normal, this is a 10 mil syringe. You can use whatever you want. I try to get it down as low to the bottom as I can. There's no point putting it in the center. You're just going to close the center. I want the bottom of my piece to close, to try to close. So I'm going to try and suck from the bottom. So, like that. I don't know whether it's going to help or not. Just got just yellow in there. So that's basically all I'm going to do. That's like probably 11 mil in there. And then I just use some isopropyl alcohol in a little cup. And I clean that out, and then I pull that back the outside and clean around there. And anyway, that's what I do. That way I can reuse my little syringe. Okay, now let's try and put this in without dripping into areas where I don't want it to go. Hold that over there. Take that right away. I'm going to be really careful this time because I dripped way over here. And I don't want to do that again. I can't see where it's going. I do want quite a lot because I don't want a big center. I'd rather have a center of glitter rather than an empty void. So I'm just kind of putting it wherever. I have no idea where it's going, if it's even in the inner circle. I have no idea. But I'm going to put a bit more in. Now you can see how the middle's going red already, or orange already. Yay, I did it without putting any, without stuffing it up. It's a bonus. I wonder what would happen if I use my heat gun on it. Like, I don't usually. I wonder if it'll help close it at all, or whether it's just going to do it, close the top. What do you think? Let's just try it. Like I do with a 3D balloon, you just, just try and heat it a little bit, push it from the sides, trying to get it to move into the middle. I don't know if it will help, but we'll just try it, shall we? Why not? Doing weird things. It must be popping bubbles. Not sure what those are. Okay, that'll do. It'll be interesting to see if it does anything. And if it does, I don't know if it's because of the heat or because I've sucked the center out or what. All right, let's just leave it like that. Let's just leave it. All right, I think I've got enough battery on my phone to give you a little time lapse, and I'll see you at the unmolding. All right, it is just after 10 p.m. and I was getting ready to go to bed, taking the dogs outside, and I thought, I'll just come and see if it's ready. And it seems ready. It's a little bit soft. Like if I push there. I could leave a little nail print, but I want to do it tonight. So this was the other one. That's what it looked like on the back. And they're very different. This one's got a lot more stuff going on. This one, because I didn't have enough white in it, it just kind of floated. And this one looks as if the white's sunk and is doing stuff. So let's have a look. And even in the middle, it looks as if it's closed up into the middle. So, but it looks as if it's quite puffy in the middle, not little tiny petals. It looks as if they're kind of floaty and puffy. But that's what it looks like on this side. I don't know if it's going to be the same on the other side. I will link my frangipani mold. This is a large one. I will link it down below for you if you would like to grab yourself one of those. All right. Are we ready? Oh, do you think it's worked? Here we go. Ooh, well, that's totally different, isn't it? Don't really know much what to make of that one. Oh, wow. Well, look at the pink. It's a much brighter pink, that's for sure. I guess it's because of the white. Because of we've had a lot more white in this one, so the pink has, you know, grabbed hold of that white. So, yeah, we've got a distinct... This one's got, it's got the same sort of puffy areas there. And then this bit in the middle, which didn't really do much. It has done more on this one, as you can see. We've got petals around there. My gold is in the center, looks nice. You can see a tiny bit of that reddish in there, not a lot. So there you go. What do you think of that one? There's the sides. And again, it has taken on, I don't know if you can see these raised bits. It's kind of taken on because it's got pink underneath. It's sort of got hints of pink in here as well. Can you guys see that? I don't know if you can see what I can see, but it's got little bits of pink. And from where I dusted it as well, I guess, it's got that little bit of pink. With that yellow, isn't that yellow pretty? It's very pretty yellow. Actually matches really nicely with the yellow in here. You'd think it was the same, hey? Look at that yellow in there to out there. It looks really pretty. So there we go. I can go to bed now. Happy with that. Pick this one up. There they are, side by side. 4 drops of white. 12 drops of white. So very, very different. I don't know which one I prefer. I do like the striations in this one. They are gorgeous. Look at the colours. Look at those striations. That matches my nail polish. We've got white, we've got pink, we've got yellow, we've got orange, all kinds of different coloured striations in that outer rim there. So I think that's really pretty. So there you go. That's Beast Bond. Probably didn't get the effect that I was probably going for, which was, oh, there it is. There. The outer edge, again, is similar. You get that outer edge with not that much going on. But then the middle here, this one's got a lot more little petals. And this was a thicker resin, so they've kind of dropped down, I think, instead of floated across. That was Promarine. So here we go. All right. Leave it at that. I'm off to bed. We'll see what I can come up with tomorrow. Maybe this needs to wait a little bit longer till it thickens up. But it's a really nice resin to use. Look at that. No bubbles. Yeah, impressed. No bubbles. All right. Better go. Thanks for watching. Take care. I'll see you all again real soon for the next video. Bye for now.